So I'm here with Councillor Robert Nemeth, also the parliamentary candidate for Hove and Portslade for the Conservative Party. So welcome back to the latest news.
Morning, Mark.
How's the campaign going? Because we're just over 4 weeks away, aren't we? And things are hotting up, aren't they?
They really are, yeah. So, I mean, we hit the ground running in Hove. We've got a fantastic team in place. Leaflets are flying out the doors, knocking on doors every single day. It's absolutely constant, and I love it. I'm really in my element, not campaigning. I love it.
Yeah, it's exciting, isn't it?
It's so exciting. Such an adrenaline rush. And
yeah. So what's coming up then on the doorstep? Is this going to be the Brexit election, or is it going to be the NHS, the police, the...
It's not just the Brexit election. It's also the leaders. There's a lot of very strong views about the leaders of the two main parties. So, I mean, you can probably guess what. The whole range of comments about each leader that I probably receive.
And what are they going to be saying? Because if that's coming up on the doorstep now, we're going to have leadership debates shortly, aren't we? So, I mean...
Yeah, I mean, I've tried to run a very, you know, happy and bright campaign.
Yeah.
And I've had people coming up to me in the street. You know, one chap yesterday skidded up next to us in a van and said, your one job is to beat Jeremy Corbyn. And I sort of said, there's more to it than that. I don't want to become an MP because people don't like Jeremy Corbyn, but yeah, there's a lot of anti-Jeremy Corbyn feeling in Hove and Portslade.
Yeah, do you feel that people have made up their minds? Because there's a lot of discussions saying that there's a soft vote out there, and that actually people make up their minds on the day. A bit like the Scottish independence referendum. A lot of people say now that they actually just made their mind up in Scotland on the actual day of the.
I mean, lots of people might suggest that they've made up their mind, but there's still a month to go. So we've got an active Liberal candidate now in Hove. So lots of people who are actually Liberal, who voted Labour, which is, in my mind, the opposite to Liberal, may well come back to the Lib Dems. So we shall see.
So what are you campaigning on then? I know we've spoken about this before, but the NHS policing, local issues...
I've reminded people that I'm an active councillor, so I kicked off the campaign just reminding people of some of the things that I've done. You know, founded the Beach Hut Association, founded the Friends of Hove Lagoon, beat the council on its awful school catchment policies, stopped the council selling Hove Library, which is this loved local institution. But the campaign isn't about that. So that was the sort of soft and friendly launch. But ultimately, it's now about the five subjects that I just mentioned, plus the B word, Brexit.
Yeah, OK. And have you covered the whole constituency now, or
we started on the suburbs, and we've worked our way in.
You've got debates coming up, haven't you? So
yeah, there's lots of groups are organising different hustings, and I'm fairly up for them. Yeah, there should be a faith hustings, a school hustings, a Jewish hustings. So we've got a few debates in the pipeline. So yeah. and I can't wait.
Okay, so what's coming up then for the next 4 weeks? Have you got any major kind of events you're going to?
Well, there's the hustings, which is the main thing. I've got all sorts of quite exciting, things that I've organised along the trail. I mean, the most boring thing being the street stall, but it's not boring when you're on the stall. It's actually really exciting. But and then lots of other smaller things along the way to sort of punctuate the message.
Yeah. Okay. Just an update on the council. What's going on at the council? So, what's coming up in your inbox at the council at the moment? We've obviously got the Valley Gardens Stage 3. I've seen.
Yeah, that doesn't come into my inbox. My inbox is all about the absolute disastrous situation under Labour locally when it comes to the bins. So, someone would tell me they voted for Labour. I say fair enough, and then they'll complain to me about the bins, and I'll say, don't you see that the two things are inextricably linked? And they sort of think, oh, maybe next time I'll actually, I'll view it that my vote counts. It has counted. The problems we've got at the moment are directly linked to the way that Labour handles the in-house bin service.
Right, OK.
And people are cross about that.
Yeah. Do you think that's going to change any time? Do you see that changing?
Well, we've got over three more years of Labour on the council, so if people in 3 years' time see the link, then I think it will change. But it's a hard message.
Okay, leave it there for now. All the best for the campaign, and I'm sure we'll catch up again soon.
Thank you,
Mark.
Thanks
for coming. Thanks.